Hey everyone, it's Bubs. I get asked so much from you all, from girls and guys, asking for advice, asking me what are your secrets to achieving such clear skin, is there any tips that you can give me? First of all, I just want to stress two things. Number one, my skin is not perfect. It is nowhere near perfect, okay? The camera and photos and etc. is very deceiving. I certainly don't have perfect skin, okay? So let's clear that up. My skin has improved a lot from how it used to be from years ago, but it's not perfect, okay? And second thing is, I know what it's like to have acne. There's one thing that kind of annoys me was when I was younger, there would be people that would try to give me advice with acne, and they obviously don't know what it's like to have acne. I know what it's like to have acne, okay? If you compare two photographs of how I look now and a photograph of how I used to look, you won't even recognize me because how different I look now. I started to get spots when I was like 12 years old, and it started off just getting, you know, just a few in my forehead. Then before I knew it, my whole entire face was covered in spots and pimples, blackheads and cysts. I know it sounds really horrible and gross, and it was very painful, okay? It was painful to touch, but what hurt more was being ashamed to look at your own reflection in the mirror. I used to dodge mirrors, and when I used to talk to people, I would not look at them in the eye. You know, with acne, I struggled for like nearly 10 years. So it took me years and years for me to realize what is really good for my skin. So yeah, today I want to talk about my experiences with acne, the essential guide to clear skin, and three tips that I really swear by. So first of all, acne. It's nothing that you should be ashamed of. It's totally normal. In fact, about 9 in 10 of us have acne, so don't worry, you are not alone. Okay, so number one, you may already know yourself, and that's water. And you're probably thinking, water, I know that, but are you drinking enough of it? Are you drinking your 8 glasses of water a day? Because it's not as if it's an option, it's something you need, kind of like air to your skin and of course your body. Water is what's going to flush all the toxins out of your body. It's what's going to cleanse your body inside out and of course your skin. So if you can, try to swap your fizzy soft drinks for water. Water is the key to hydration, and your skin needs to be hydrated. If your skin is not hydrated, it will break out, because you need moisture in your skin. And if you drink enough water, you will see the difference in your skin. Next up is sleep. Are you getting enough of it? Sleep is very important, guys, because when you sleep, your skin heals itself. It's when your skin cells will renew and regenerate itself. So therefore, if you don't sleep enough, you're not allowing this to happen. And also, if you get enough sleep, it means your stress levels will lower, so it means that your hormones will be all over the place and it lessens the chance of you breaking out. Whereas if you don't get enough sleep, your skin will look dull, it could even look dry, and most likely your skin will break out if you're not sleeping enough. So definitely get your sleep. They don't call it beauty sleep for nothing. So for example, if you sleep in a dark, quiet room, it means you're gonna sleep better, and when you have a good night's sleep, you can definitely see it in your skin. Try to sleep on your back if you can. I know a lot of people like to sleep, you know, like this or, you know, like this, but it's actually best for your skin if you sleep on your back, because if you sleep on your side, you can cause premature sagging, and the bacteria from the pillow can transfer to your face. Whereas if you're sleeping on your back, it means that your hair is brushed away from your face. Also, because of gravity, it kind of gives you like facelift because it pulls your skin back. So this is just one thing to work on and think about. So now hygiene. Hygiene is very important. So it's good that you cleanse your skin in the morning and nighttime to remove the dirt, the oil, everything. But what about the things in between? Things like sleeping on a dirty pillow, talking on your mobile phone, using an old facial flannel, sleeping with dirty hair. You know, all of these can cause us to break out. I actually try to wash my hair every night if I can, because I just don't like the thought of all the oil and grease traveling down my face, and especially if you use hairspray or, you know, styling products that are very likely to transfer onto the pillow, then I recommend you to wash your hair before you go to sleep. So before you touch your face, make sure your hands are nice and clean. And so try to avoid touching your face so much, because your hands actually have a lot of bacteria in them. If you wear makeup, make sure your makeup brushes are clean, your makeup sponges are clean. So if your room is dusty or, I don't know, just dirty, give it a good spring clean. Because when environment is clean, you can feel it and you'll be less self-conscious and you'll stress less. These all come together and affects the impact of your skin. So exercise, and you're probably thinking, what does exercise have anything to do with clearing up my skin? Well, actually, does play a good role. Number one, it increases blood circulation, which is really, 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 really good for your skin. Number two, when you exercise, you lower your stress. And when your stress is lowered, it means, in general, you feel good about yourself. And of course, there's less chance of you breaking out. Now, one thing you must do after you exercise is to shower, wash your face, just wash yourself, because sweat mixed with oil and everything could cause you to break out. So of course, beauty is skin deep. It's not completely what products you use, it's also what you are, what you eat. Make sure you have a good intake of foods that are good for you, such as foods that are high in antioxidants, which are going to cleanse your body. When your body is cleansed, it will show up in your skin. Body cleansing foods such as lemons, tomato, strawberries, blueberries, these all come together to cleanse your body, especially lemon. Lemon is a really good detoxer for the body and skin. Try to minimize foods that are high in fat. Say that foods that are high in fats show up as a form of excess oil in your skin. Is there anything that you are allergic to? When I eat dairy foods, my skin tends to break out. And it's the same for my family members as well. So it could be generic. Moisturize. When I was younger, I used to think that, you know, because my skin was so oily already, I was like, if I moisturize even more, my skin is just going to be even more oilier. All I did was cleanse my skin. And I thought that, you know, if I keep on cleaning my skin will just be really clean and it means I won't break out. And how wrong was that? My skin was stripped from moisture. It was so dry. And because it was so dry, my skin was trying to replenish the oil levels. It was trying to combat the dryness by producing sebum. So this leads to the skin producing excess sebum, which means excess oil, which means my pores getting clogged and then breakouts. So in order to have clear skin, you must moisturize. So to find a good moisturizer, go for one that's oil-free. If you have sensitive skin, I actually recommend you guys to stay away from cream moisturizers and go for gel instead, a light formula that doesn't clog your pores and doesn't agitate you. So next up is identifying your skin type. I have an oily T-zone, which is my forehead, you know, my nose, my chin, but my cheeks are really dry. If you have combination skin like I do, then go for a range that is formulated for combination skin. If you have dry skin, you need a range that's going to moisturize your skin. If you have oily skin, you need products that can regulate your oil levels. If you have sensitive skin, then obviously stay away from harsh products. Product-wise, I do believe that products can improve your skin quite a lot. They can help, but only to a certain extent. You can use the most expensive stuff in the world for your skin, but your skin may never ever hit its potential because you can't just rely on the outside. You know, it's also your lifestyle, it's what you eat, it's what you drink. So that's the thing, don't rely on products. A cleanser is what's going to remove the dirt, the oil, and the makeup from your skin every morning and every night. And I don't recommend you guys to cleanse more than twice a day. Only if you exercise, then it's fine for you to cleanse more often. There are a bunch of cleansers in the market and, you know, I've tried so many of them. Like Neutrogena, I find that Neutrogena products, they are able to clean your skin gently and not dry out your skin at the same time. So that's what I like about Neutrogena. Instead of trying to work your skin really quickly for quick results, it does it nice and slowly. So the cleanser I swear by is from Laneige, and it's the multi cleanser. So I've been using this cleanser for a long time now. I've never used a cleanser as long as Laneige. So this product removes my makeup completely. You know, it really cleans everything off your face, and it's got these tiny micro beads, and you can't even feel it exfoliating your skin. And it would exfoliate your skin gently, removing dirt, oil, and dead skin cells. The ingredients in this product helps my skin to regenerate and heal itself. So now onto toner. A toner is something that you use after you cleanse your face, and it kind of acts like a reassurance, you know, to cleanse your skin, and also can be used to refine your pores, because alcohol toners tend to really, really dry out your skin. And again, when your skin is really dry, it's going to produce excess sebum. This is from the Pore Trouble range. Stops me from breaking out. And again, the ingredients inside helps my skin to renew itself. And now onto moisturizers, and I talked about them earlier. Go for a moisturizer that caters your skin type. And like I said before, go for a moisturizer that's oil-free so it doesn't clog your pores. I'm told that if you have acne or sensitive skin, go for a moisturizer that's of gel consistency rather than cream. So again, I use Laneige. So you can see it's a gel texture. And if I just go like this, you can see it's just like water. And yeah, it's enough for my skin to absorb it and really hydrate my skin. Of course, treating your skin every so often when you can with masks. Convenient time would be after your bath or after you shower. So because the steam will open up your pores, it means it's the best time to apply the mask because, you know, it's going to absorb better. So there's many different types of facial masks, a clay mask. Very often these are cleansing masks. They work as a magnet, drawing out all the impurities in your skin. It's exfoliating masks, and it means that there's going to be little beads that's going to exfoliate your skin, and removing dead skin cells, removing impurities. It's basically removing the dirt and dry skin that accumulates on the surface of the skin. And if you don't exfoliate enough, your pores can become blocked. So it's very important that you exfoliate. When it comes to products, that's the thing about recommending stuff, because everybody's different, you know. Your skin reacts differently to other people. And honestly, it took me years and years through trial and error to find out what works best for me, guys. So I think the best advice that I would give is to listen to your own skin, listen to your body. Use a product and it's not working very well for you, then your skin will find its own way to tell you. Something that I really love to do is to steam my face. And you can get little facial steamers in, I don't know, Boots or any beauty department store. And if you don't have one, just get a bowl of water, boil of boiling water, and just hover your face over and just let the steam open up your pores. Squeeze a few drops of lemon in, and the lemon will help to cleanse your skin as well. Letting your skin breathe. So if it's possible, only wear makeup when it's necessary. So if you do wear makeup every day, then make sure that the foundation or whatever you're wearing isn't going to clog your pores. But it is important for you to let your skin breathe. So before you go to bed, make sure that you remove all traces of makeup. I know a lot of teenage girls would rely quite heavily on cleansing wipes. I can see why, you know, they're very convenient. So if you're traveling whatsoever, you can just bring these little wipes, but don't completely rely on wipes. What you don't know is with makeup wipes, they can cause an imbalance of pH in your skin. So those are the essential tips to clear skin, and it does seem very simple, doesn't it, guys? It is simple. Really, it took me years and years for me to realize that what I really needed to do was to follow these instead of trying to look for shortcuts and just rely on products. It's definitely more than just products, guys. It's how you live your life, it's your diet, it's how much sleep you get, how much water you drink. You know, these all play a big role. So now I'm going to tell you guys the three skin essential tips that I swear by. So one thing that I really swear by is green tea. I drink green tea every single day, and I have no doubt that this is what helps to keep my skin clear. Green tea is very high in antioxidants, and it is what helps to fight the free radicals. So not only it's anti-aging, it's also anti-inflammatory. Green tea also helps to speed up your metabolism as well. So yeah, ever since drinking green tea, my skin has definitely improved loads. Because green tea cleanses your body inside out, and when your body is healthy, it shows up on your skin. Next thing that I really swear by is natural remedies. Nothing works better to me than using natural resources. There's so many different home remedies that you could try. One of my favorite masks is just a simple natural yogurt, oatmeal, and honey. These three come together, really hydrates your skin, it helps to treat spots, and exfoliates your skin. You guys are going to have to trust me on this, because it's going to sound really fickle, but you guys are going to have to trust me. In order to achieve clear skin, you guys are going to have to believe that you will have clear skin, and you're like, okay, whatever, Bubby. When you make these changes to your lifestyle, you also have to believe in yourself. Just stop stressing about your skin. Stop letting your skin rule your life. When you stop stressing and just thinking too much into your own skin, then your body will eventually listen to your mind. The best advice my doctor has ever given me was to tell me that if I want good skin, I have to believe I'll have good skin. Flashback a few years ago, it was very difficult for me to look at the mirror, see my reflection, you know, of a girl with so many spots in my face, and you know, it was hard for me to tell myself that, you know, Lindy, you're going to have clear skin. The day that I stopped to worry about my skin was the day that my skin started to improve. All in all, it's all about your diet, your lifestyle, the products that you use, and also you believing in yourself. I had to deal with it, and yeah, even though I had to say it's a pain in the ass, but you know, it's a part of my life and it was a part of who I am. And you really have to love yourself. You know, nobody is perfect and it's your imperfections that make you beautiful. So if you have some spots, focus on your good points. Your eyes, your smile, your dimples, your hair, you're healthy, you're loved. So I hope this long video was helpful to you guys. My throat is going. And good luck to everyone. So take care, everyone. Bye.